俄罗斯监狱管理局亚马尔涅涅茨地区管理分局16日发布消息称，俄罗斯反对派人士纳瓦利内在狱中死亡。据路透社报道，纳瓦利内当天在狱中散步后感觉不适，随即失去知觉。劳教所医务工作人员赶到，并呼叫了紧急医疗救助组，实施了所有必要的抢救措施，但未取得积极效果。纳瓦利内已被确认死亡。俄罗斯总统新闻秘书佩斯科夫在受访时表示，俄罗斯监狱管理局正在按照有关程序对纳瓦利内的死因进行调查。阿列克谢·纳瓦利内生于1976年，现年47岁。他是俄罗斯国内知名反对派领袖，多次批评总统普京。他过去多次被判监禁，包括俄罗斯法院之前在2023年8月4日裁定纳瓦利内包括极端主义在内的一连串罪名成立，令其被加刑19年。他的盟友法德耶娃2023年12月也因被判极端主义罪获刑9年。2020年8月19日，纳瓦利内曾在搭乘飞机返回莫斯科时遭人下毒，情况一度危急。纳瓦利内之死引发美欧多国领导人对俄罗斯总统普京的批评，指责普京应对此负责。
You know, like millions of people around the world, I'm literally both not surprised and outraged by the news. Reported death of Alexei Navalny. He bravely stood up, to the corruption, the violence, and all the bad things that the Putin government was doing. In response, Putin had him poisoned, he had him arrested, he had him prosecuted for fabricated crimes, he sentenced him to prison, he was held in isolation. Even all that didn't stop him from calling out Putin's lies. Even in prison, he was a powerful voice for the truth, which is kind of amazing when you think about it.Reports of his death, if they're true, and I have no reason to believe they're not, Russian authorities are going to tell their own story. But make no mistake, Putin is responsible for Navalny's death. Putin is responsible.